I want to greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Firstly, I want to appreciate the pastor for allowing me to stand before you this morning. And I also want to express my heartfelt condolences to him and the family. Also the church for the funeral that just went out
there.
I was very much overwhelmed with the support, especially from the elders of the church. I was very much encouraged of how you have been standing with your pastor. The other day, Elder Mawango and the wife and Brother Manyeche,
the other day,
the Lord bless you. The Lord also bless the pastor and the family. I came to Zimbabwe this time just to come and express my thanksgiving. Because I have always said to this church, and also I have always said wherever I have gone, you have a good pastor. One of the blessed churches in the message today,
History
Church is one of them. You have a good pastor. Your pastor has been a parent to me. And I think I'm one of the blessed believers in the message today. To have given me my pastor, Pastor Ron Kapisha in Zambia, who has brought us up in the admonition of the Lord. He made us meet people. Servants of God that have been a blessing to our lives. And one of those people is your pastor. Pastor Chesa has seen me grow in the message. Just like many of the elders here, he has called me the son, he has called me the friend, and History Tabernacle is one of the pulpits that I preach my heart at. And the pastor here has been very helpful to my physical and spiritual life. So I have been out of the country for many years. He came to South Africa. He told me to do certain things. And then I did. And then he was one of the people that was telling me to go back home. I've been out of Zambia for over 20 years. Trying to do this. I was in Botswana. 13 years I left Botswana. Went to South Africa. And then this January I relocated back to Zambia. So I came this time to meet him and to express my gratitude for all what he has been to me in my life. I have been employed officially now with a company probably you have heard about, Edmark International. As a general manager for Zambia. So I came.
So I remembered where the blessing came from.
And
I wanted to just come and appreciate the pastor.
And
we have brothers. Elders here in the church who have been praying for me. And so the Lord bless the pastor for everything that they have been doing together with his family. I am not staying. I have to go tomorrow. I'm going back to Zambia. But I'm in Zimbabwe. That's what Pastor Madongo said. I hold two nationalities. So it's nice to be with you here this morning in the house of the Lord. And my message is very short this morning. And, I just want to empower the church. I want to encourage the church. I want to bring some spiritual tips. Do you know that we have got tips in the message? We tip one another. That's a tip.
Anti-tip.
So, we thank God for the message of the hour.
And,
we are rejoicing. So, I've got some tips that I want to speak to the church.
That,
yes, we wait for the coming of the Lord. We have to know those things. So, the elder says I should sing. And I want to sing this song. Take your burdens to the Lord and leave it there. Take your burdens to the Lord. I'm living there. Take your burden, oh the Lord. Give me that song, my brother. I'm living there. That's the instruction. That we take our burdens to the Lord and leave them there. Because a human being was not made to carry burdens. And because he was not made to carry burdens, if he tries to carry burdens, he breaks down easily. Amen. So Jesus comes and says, bring all your burdens and leave them there. I'll carry them for you. The kingdom of Satan is worry, frustration, murmuring, complaining, but the kingdom of our God is peace, joy, grace. Take your burdens to the Lord. Leave it there. Take your burdens to the Lord and leave it there. If you
trust will never come. It will show you, bring you out. Take your God and serve the one I need. Leave the if the world from your windows of its silver and its gold, and you have to get on with being a fan, just remember in this world how we fulfill the true word. Bet your brother to the Lord, I need you there. Take your parents to the Lord, I need a prayer. If you trust and never doubt, it will surely bring you out. Take your mother to the Lord, I need a prayer. What is a love spring? I'm your help, you can't take me. And your soul is almost sinking in despair. Jesus loves the pain you feel. He can send and he can help now. Take your hand to the Lord. Let your heart heal the Lord, I will pray. Listen, when your enemies assemble and your heart begins to fail, don't forget that God in heaven he answers prayer. He will make a way for you and will lead you safely through. Take your pain to the Lord and leave them here. And leave them here. Take your pain to the Lord and leave them here. If you trust and never doubt, they will surely bring you out. Take your burden to the Lord and leave them here. Oh, leave it there. Leave it there. Take your burden to the Lord and leave it there. If you trust and never doubt, he will surely bring you out. Take your burdens. Take your burdens. Take your burdens to the Lord. Amen. Amen. Jesus, just to mention all of your name. Flowers grow, the deserts bloom again. Black fire in winter fall. That pure, precious God, Jesus, just to mention all your name. Jesus, just to mention all your name. Flowers grow, the deserts bloom again. Like fire in winter clouds, like pure, precious gold. Mention all your name. I love little to Jesus. I love little to Him. If I am ever anything, I will be told to you.
Amen.
If you are ever anything, oh yes, my brother, you will be told to you.
Hallelujah.
If you are ever anything, oh, hallelujah, you only told,
hallelujah,
I only told to Jesus. If I am ever anything,
I will
be
my heavenly home is right on faith.
Oh, yes.
I feel like traveling on. So there ain't no taking me down there. I feel like traveling on. Yes, I feel like traveling on. I feel like traveling on. Heavenly mansion shall be mine.
So don't be jealous of us. We are rejoicing. Because something has happened. Florence, something has happened. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 11. In his time.
He meant so things.
He hath made everything beautiful in his time. So as the Shambas, we are rejoicing. Where is Florence?
She's going to work.
Okay. So, Baba, Uncle, we are rejoicing. We had
a husband.
And if we are dogs, our tails would be doing like that. You can't marry from book face. They call it what? Book face. Facebook. You can't marry from
Facebook.
Neither can you find a husband through internet. You are going to be interneted until you die. Prayer is the best thing.
Hallelujah.
Listening to your pastor is the best thing. I'm telling you. This message has given us everything. And until, brother, you marry properly, that's why you are going to do that. It pays to listen to your
daughter.
You can't find the person in the universe and say, how do I love you?
If I am
that, So, book first is not working. Can I get an amen from the young people? Young brothers and young sisters. Book first does not work. Because we, I know why I'm talking like that. We have seen things. We have seen things from Facebook. She'll be putting on those black goggles. You think that is somebody, not knowing that somebody doesn't have eyes properly.
So,
Uncle, we are very thankful for
Florence.
Where is Sister Anna Chesa?
Anna Chesa.
Another joy in the family. Is it Anna's getting married?
Anna.
Where is she? Praise the Lord. Babu. Yes. It's a blessing.
Amen.
I don't want to go into that direction. So I'm asking the church to stand on our feet. I've got three portions of the message. That is Genesis 11, verse 1 to 6.
Genesis 11, Mark 1, chapter 6.
Romans 12, verse 1 to 2.
Romans 4.
Philippians 4, verse
8.
So we have three questions to read. And as usual, I'll just ask Uncle Shama to come and pray. So let's bow our heads for prayer this morning.
Anoint my brother, anoint the interpreter, anoint the listeners, that at the end of the service, we will all be full of joy, full of praise. We ask for everything in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Now, I want us, the church, to read with me the scriptures. So we shall read from verse 1 together.
Verse 6
of Genesis chapter 11.
Genesis 11, verse 1.
Shall we read it together? And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. And it came to pass, as they journeyed from the east, that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they said one to another, "Go to them, let us make brick and burn them fire." And they had brick for stone, and slag and lead for mortar. And they said, "Go to them, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth." And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower, which the children of men built. And the Lord said, "Behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do." I want you to notice verse 6.
So that we check it by 6.
That the happenings on earth,
which is not capanica
by man,
Nemunu,
God acknowledged
it.
In other words, God is convinced that their plans were going to work.
Why is Roshana?
Yes. God is admitting
them.
Now, if you come to the message, Brother Branham says it was wrong motives here. You believe that? But wrong motives, when God looks at wrong motives, He says it will work. Something that is wrong convinces God in heaven that whatever they are thinking, if we wait, and Brother Branham in that message, he says they were going to build up that seat and it was going to reach heaven. When there are troubles on earth, they run into heaven and they sit with God. When the troubles are over, they come down, they continue with their lives. It was going to happen. And I'll tell you the reason why. The Lord bless the reading of His holy message. I want you to read with me again. Romans chapter 12.
Romans 12.
Precious brother, verse 1 to 2. Let's read it together, church, again. Shall we go? I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. The Lord bless the reading of His word. The only way, Brother Jonathan, cannot the will of God is when his mind has been changed from the earthly mind, having the mind of Christ inside him. Then that will make you, when you come across things, you are going to prove this teaching is good, and this
teaching
is acceptable, and this
teaching
is the perfect will of God. It is when the mind has been transformed. When the mind is not transformed, is what we are getting in the world. Learned people, very educated
people,
with nice suits, they can sit somewhere and debate over things that are against nature. And one of the things why personally I love your president,
Chantilla, President,
you are Uncle Bob. I am praying that God should give a lot of years to Uncle Bob. So that Uncle Bob can teach other statesmen that should not make us change the way of God. I am planning to visit Uncle Bob one of these days and to give him a message. No, that is very true. I'm not joking. I am planning to meet the ambassador in Zambia or Zimbabwe, because I've been to their office. I want to ask for the appointment.
No,
I want to greet that man.
Is that an only thing you need to move
down?
Now I can go to my grave. We call him a politician.
But
he thinks more better than people are calling themselves Christians.
Okay. I am not preaching politics. I just love Uncle Bob because he has really embraced me that
moment.
It is better we suffer the economy in Zimbabwe, but we are still holding on to the word of God. We enjoy that. That is coming from section. How do you develop a country? By allowing homosexuality in the country so that we can have better roads and better petrol and better money and high salaries because of homosexuality. No! Let us be without the jobs, but we go on to the world. God will make a way for us. In the time of famine, because we have the word, with our help and clear, God will make a way for us. So, long live Uncle Bob. Long live.
It's better.
Where ministers can come, even in the public way, you can write an article and say the thing against homosexuality. Did you know that? Yes! It's only Zimbabwe.
What's Zimbabwe?
Amen.
That's
right. Yeah. That's why we want even to shift to come to Zimbabwe and be at
Pastor
Chesa. I haven't started preaching yet. I'll tell you when I start preaching. Philippians chapter 4.
Whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think of these
things.
Now listen. Do you know what the Spirit of God says like that?
We must not the same way our work at our Israel.
Because a human being who is a spirit.
Yeah.
You have got a mental faculty. That is now like a control room.
anoita ndiwo nzvimbo inochimakirira maitiro ako.
The things that you read.
Zvinhu zvaunoverenga.
The things that you hear.
Zvinhu zvaunonzwa.
The things that you see.
Zvinhu zvaunoona.
They affect your natural life.
Zvinokanganisa upenyu hwako zvakanyanya.
What is good news today?
Now, not zakanaka.
It is actually bad news according to the Bible.
Zvinenge zvichinoda zvakai pakatama Bible.
That's why
because saka
they say
that not
a proper business person
munhu muzvina bhizinesi chaiye
will not buy a newspaper and read it in the morning when he's going to work.
Take a newspaper and tell him about an agenda pass.
Because
he put in
some news.
Zvimwe nhau zvirimo
zvepafect.
Zvinokanganisa.
So he will be a disturbed person throughout the day. So proper business people, they read the news. When they are relaxing and completing travel, that's when they are reading the news. Because the job is done. And it is true.
It's your money.
Don't buy newspapers and you are coming to church. You won't be in the service.
Amen.
Amen.
Now,
Amen.
I reached this spot in Zambia. This is the third or fourth time. I just want to encourage the church. Because when I read that quotation that I want to read, God loves us.
My man,
believers of this message,
the shock of my
God loves us.
My man,
brother, we are sitting under that ministry. That ministry is a unique ministry. Under that ministry, we have got no questions.
You are with your wife.
It is in the middle of the night. And the people are cracking your door there. My question is this. Who wakes up first? Who wakes up first? Who is gonna go to the door? Then you are not thinking properly, sir. Now, I'm gone. Why is it written that? When there is a knock at the door, in the night, the one who must wake up is the man, not the wife.
Where is it by chance?
Upon.
Nature. That is under
that
I just started preaching. I'm enjoying myself in Adam. By the way, has been reported that in
Harare,
the believers, they don't go home on Sunday. Because when we are somewhere there, they tell us that Jonathan, this is the message of the hour. We must go to the hour. My thought this morning is this. The power
Simba
of the human How interesting it is,
you know,
to know that our thoughts, they play a major role, important role, critical role. In our lives. And this morning, I just want to give some tips to the believers of this message. Because the brother prayed, we are in the evil age. There has never been an age evil like this one. And the place where the devil has played on people, he has played on their minds.
Yes, sir.
That's
right. Until Paul, in the spirit, he says, First Timothy chapter 4, in the latter days, people shall depart from the faith. They shall give hints,
abusing
spirits, and their consciences will be heightened with the
Lord.
And when the conscience of a man is high with the water, the condition of that man is the opposite of the power of judgment. The power of human thoughts. Amen. I want to provoke you this morning that you can go in your spiritual life and get a license, apply for a license, and go to him and tell Jesus, Lord, I give you the license, come and drive the car of my thoughts.
Yes, sir.
Lord, he said, I want you,
did not die,
to drive the car of my thoughts. I want to be the passenger.
Did not
become the driver. Because the nature
management of human thoughts is one of the greatest responsibilities
for the church.
Human thoughts.
Yeah.
And I say this, the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the house you live in, the car that you drive, the job that you do, the place where you are living, the business that you are doing, it is all propelled by your thoughts.
I will repeat that statement.
The clothes you wear, the food you eat, the car you drive, the life you lead, the job you are doing, the business that you are doing, the place where you live, the house you live in, it is all propelled by
your.
That is how powerful.
Your
thoughts are.
I'm inviting you to the message that Brother Brenham,
you have a Brenham,
he preaches. And you know how he calls that message? He says this. The greatest battle.
Not which ones? No, not that will be. But he says the greatest battle. In Zimbabwe they say battle. In Zambia we say battle. So don't worry whether battle or battle or people. We are talking about the greatest battle. The power. Of human thoughts.
Amen.
He says the greatest battle ever fought. Even now, the people are in the church. But that battle is still raging. But they are seated in the church.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Some as they were coming from home. They fought. The husband beat the wife. The wife beat the husband. Then they dressed up. And they came to church. They are not talking to one another. But they in the church. But when the husband said,
Amen.
The wife at the back says, you hypocrite. But they are in the church. And those spirits, they affect the service. Sometimes you start to see, even to preach, you start to find that ministers they understand better. It's better. Some, they are struggling because there is no job. By the way the brother breathes, by the way he does his body, you will know that he is talking something inside you. I'm okay. There is a battle going on here. The greatest battle ever fought. If I go home, is there trouble? If I go home, maybe they have cut the electricity. If I go home, I don't have a house. We are living in the rented house. And every time it's hiking. Now this is 3 months. We are going to pay. People, they are in the church. On the things that are pure. On the things that are holy. On the things that are lovely. Think for those things.
Amen.
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 On the things. that are of good report.
Some people, they specialize in wrong information. Imagine. There's a newspaper. Junior Kadiwa.
Junior
makes it to America.
Either for America.
In the final exams.
My final exam.
That message?
So very
good message.
Shobrakadaka.
Right?
Yes,
that's a good message.
Shobrakadaka.
That's the reason the father's been paying late and your school fees there. It is that his child should be paid. And people will be taking phones. Good or bad news has become good news. That's why a believer must not keep bad news. They affect you. In one way or the other, you are affected. Look! He's right. And these
journalists,
they know how to get your mind, how to attract your mind. The thing is that Satan wants your mind to be bombarded with evil. You are in the church. You are meditating. Lord Jesus Christ, I will thank your Father for your
blessing.
You start remembering those things.
Yeah.
Your meditation
will be affected.
The power of the human thoughts. So, Brother Brennan says, the greatest battle ever fought. I have put four paragraphs.
Four
of that message. And I want the brother to give me. This message is 1962. March 11th. And Brother Brennan says, paragraph 64.
Paragraph 64.
Now,
because you know,
before any battle,
what is such a
will be put in a ring.
Is such a is what I'm talking about.
Is it okay if I can take up this denomination? I feel that it is holding me. Thank you, my brother.
Before any battle
can be put in a ring,
they
first have to choose a meeting ground or a place where the battle is to be fought. A selected place.
68.
When this great battle started on earth, they had to be a mutual meeting place. They had to be a place selected for the battle to begin. And for the battle to break, and that battleground
being
in the human mind, the head,
Musoro.
Are you listening? Paragraph 69.
Paragraph 69.
Okay, before that, he says, the head,
Musoro.
He says,
Adotin.
The human mind,
Fuman
Yamun, the man. That's where the battle,
Imamo Wodo,
starts.
Nobody attacked him.
The human mind,
Fuman
was chosen for the place of the battle, where it was begin. That is because that decisions are made from the mind.
Are
you?
having difficulty to find that one?
Muruku nesigeru kawana.
Thank you, my brother. Can you go up there? We are used to this technology. So thank God for Jay for bringing technology to us.
68.
He says, the human mind was chosen for the place of the battle, where it was begin. And that is because the decisions are made from the mind, the head. Now let me stop here and take you to Ephesians chapter 6. We are not going to read. Just listen. You have read about the uniform. You have read about the armor. That God provides for a Christian. Because finally, my brethren, put on the armor.
And I thought that is the end of the army.
just a scratch of paint.
What is it for?
You know, it's a way
of knowledge,
zero,
and protection. Of what? The human force. Do you know that your victory as a Christian is in your thoughts? Do you know as a Christian, failure is by your thoughts? How many here have read the message? Do you fear cancer?
Yeah.
If you go to that report, that brother was reporting that report. He says, when that death
and the group
of cancer was rising up in America, if there was such a spirit around it, that America was terrorized by cancer in such a way that the fear of the disease made people to get sick of cancer when they have no cancer. People were getting sick. They visit their relatives. And they see how their relatives are. And that's the fear of the people
who
have cancer. How did it start? Fear. To where? Thoughts. The power of your thoughts. I go back to the quotation.
You know the quotation?
Brother Bernard, paragraph 69. Take him
out.
The
woman
says, I want this little girl here.
You know
that is very sick.
To
be sure to listen now to this. When Brother Bernard is explaining about the human mind, there was a girl that was sick. And Brother Benham says, that's why I want this girl to listen to this. Why? Healing is in your thoughts. As much as healing is in your thoughts, my brother, sister, even the diseases that are in our thoughts. It's amazing. That's why I'm saying, we thank God for that ministry. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Thank God for medium breath. Because now, we know that healing is in your thoughts.
Amen.
Disease can come upon you by the way your thoughts are being prepared. Is it not in this message where a man wrote on a piece of paper, I am sick of tuberculosis, and he wrote that prayer to Brother Brenner, I'm sick, this is it,
is yours.
And the prophet says, I
held
under that anointing. I held it. I said, but you are okay. No, I'm sick. What was speaking? Brother Branham says, what is the word? Words are thoughts expressed. That's what we have learned under that ministry. When you are speaking things, you are after transmitting your thoughts.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
He says, I am sick. The prophet says, okay. Because you desire this song. From yesterday, you start with your wife.
and you wanted to come and expose God, can you expose God?
So you have it.
And the man failed him.
With the two
letting him. So,
too much.
Now,
well, you know,
I want you to keep quiet. Just keep quiet for 1 second. Let's go. You are quiet. You are quiet, isn't it? That's being quiet. Brother, how can you say the church was quiet? When I told them to keep quiet, the church was so quiet until we had the projector making us outside. Okay, let's be quiet. And I want you to hear. Those who are going to hear, you must say you are quiet. Let's be quiet. How many have had the projector outside? The generator, sorry. In Zambia we call it projector, there's no problem. You see? Thoughts! We are quiet! Brother, this is the thought I want to tell you. Brother Branham says, there is only one thing on the earth that has managed to make noise in heaven. Only one thing on the earth that when it makes noise, God they are making noise. And that is the human voice.
Amen.
Thoughts are powerful. They can even make noise if you have and disturb God.
There can be a bomb here. That voice is useless. Somebody can whisper.
That
noise is useless. There is only one type of a noise that has managed to travel all these millions of miles. And they go and know what God will do. And say, how can you know we are here?
That's human.
And as quiet as the church is, this morning, there is a lot of noise. But I have not come to condemn you. Turn around and say, Brother Jonathan is not here to condemn you. Brother, I am not here to condemn you. I want you, as a believer, to know the management of the thoughts. And rather, it will be a blessing. Quietness is not humbleness. Quietness is not humbleness. Many times, a certain quietness is a sign of a demon. There is a quietness which is a temperament. That is how a human being is. But some quietness, it is a demon. And Jesus Christ casted out a lot of those demons. Brother Branham says, I want this little girl here that's very sick to be sure to listen now to this little close. Paragraph 70. Thank you, my brother. Decisions are made in the mind, the head. That is where Satan makes you. And the decisions are because that God made a man that way. Satana is meeting that young girl in the mind this morning. When she was coming to church, a boyfriend sent a message. Just when she was coming.
You are Egyptian. Your eyes look like a sun. You are the rose of Sharon. Your neck is like the towers of New York.
And when our girl was coming,
she was reading that message. But she's coming to church.
I have changed my neck.
And she's in there. Once in a while, when everybody's laughing, she speaks before. She says, my neck.
Amen.
My neck. Satana has made her right in the service. He is talking to her that she must miss the preacher. Decisions are made in the mind. There is where Satan meets you, and the decisions are because that God made a man that way.
Now,
the theme of my message, where I got this expression, I told you that I have not started preaching. So please, I have not started preaching. I will tell you that now I have started. So I will just lay my background. We go together.
Because
no
fire at
all.
We are so
young. Now, yes, the confession that gave me this expression. I want to do something very
careful.
It is a message. Life. 57-06-02. Your brother Brennan, my brother, has just read the scripture which was found in Psalms. And after reading that scripture, you just go to where he read that scripture, because I want to read with the church. And Brother Brennan says, now may our Lord add his blessing to this word. My subject this morning is found in L-I-F-E. Four little letters. Can you go up, my brother? Can you go up? Go up again. Go up. Just go to where it starts. Go up there. Now. He says, now I have selected today. If it is be the will of the Lord. My subject is found in the book of Psalms. So he reads that scripture. And after he has read that scripture, I'm not aware of reading. Then Brother Brennan says, go up
with it. Now,
because you know, may our Lord add his blessing to this word. My subject this morning is found in L-I-F-E. And as the psalmist here was speaking, then now that is the quotation. Just listen. Always, God deals with men just according to the way that their minds
run.
Always, not sometimes. And the way you are this morning, in your mindset, that is the way the Lord is going to deal with you. You are 45 years old. You are 50 years old. The way your mind on the earth has been running, that is how the Lord has been doing. Because man has been put on a free moral. Always, God deals with man.
Just according to the way that their mind
runs.
And I say this.
Combat. It is the way your mind is
running.
That demon.
Demon
is a circle. That demon is evil.
Yeah.
And people that have read about the poverty and understand the poverty, they have said it is the cousin of the devil. Poverty. Poverty is so evil. That when somebody is laughing, who is the poverty stricken? It looks like he's crying. But the brother is laughing. Don't laugh, brother, sister. That demon is evil. And as a church of the living God, we must deny that demon from our families. We must keep it coming from our hands. Because poverty is evil. The brother is laughing. But when you see him, you think that he's laughing. He's crying.
Rabbi,
I saw you crying. No, I was actually laughing. He looks like he's crying. When that man is sleeping, especially these people don't have tractors in themselves. You know the tractors I'm talking about? Some people, when they are sleeping, they have got tractors. If a person does not have tractors and is sleeping, nothing that is there.
Poverty.
I can tell you that.
Look at something.
To be poor is not a sign of spirituality. To be rich is not a sign of spirituality. And therefore, we have to balance things. And this guy here is doing because this one has got no manners. Pastor says, let's bow our heads, let's keep quiet. He has got no manners, this one. My father is rich. You are lying. If your father is rich, why don't you give me
some?
Everybody here who has suffered in their lives. It's not a thing that we want to be a part of church. We have to plan for our children. We have to be like an aunt that can plan for the future. Our parents, they never plan for our future. That's why you people, you young children, who have got the parents that are supporting you to school, thank God every day of your life.
Yes, sir. force ourselves to go to school. We do not go to school. Poverty. Sometimes you come, you meet the brother, like this country here. You meet the brother. He's saying that he's suffering. I look at the person and I say, does this one know how to suffer? What is happening? Because there is no chicken in the house, he's suffering. Because of the shepherd. Do you know what suffering is? This is a tent.
In a tent.
When I was growing, my father was poor. He born us 13 children. But he has got no future. You are producing children on earth like
mine.
If you gather the children, you can make a lesser school. We don't want you to make a lesser school. Plan for your children. It is not fulfilling scripture. It is after breaking scripture. And when a person is dead, it's lying here. Then you say, there is so rest in peace. He was a good brother. Which peace? He has left 12 children on earth, and in the church of the living God, turns out to be an orphanage. Yes, thank you, my brother. Let me greet your hand. God have mercy. The church of the living God, these people, they can't sleep. The demons can't sleep. Because Jonathan has left 12 children. And when you see them, they are so of the same age. You don't know which one are we
saying.
What's the problem?
That is your chin.
And you are sleeping here. And you have dreamed brothers that have died.
How can my brother
with the Holy Ghost start pinching you when you are sleeping? May he be so
restless.
He never planned for the children. He never had plans. All what he knew was to produce children. A young girl so young. But she looks like Mandela's grandma. What's the problem?
That was cheap.
Let me finish up my story. My father was very poor. And I remember one time. We had no bed. We had no blankets. Mom took the sacks. Four sacks. And she made a pocket. Very big pocket. Then she went to a Mzungu. This missionary at the hospital there, the loan. So this guy was cutting that loan. My mother went to beg that loan. And then my mother put it in the sack. And one time, we had no bed. My father, he went and asked for a tent. And it was good
lights.
And I sleep here. I have a brother here. A younger brother. Then we do like this. That's our
blanket.
And when my younger brother we went, we started
sleeping.
Who do you want your children to live that kind of life?
No.
My brother says, deny poverty.
Hallelujah!
Deny poverty. You have power. in the name of the Lord Jesus, you get denied all rights. Because the ministry that we have has power to break the bondage of poverty. And plan for these children.
Amen.
A good man. That's right. A good man.
We will live in a disadvantage.
A good man. A good man. This good man. We will live in inheritance to his son and to the sons of his son.
Never Is
that Bible? Yes.
Oh.
A good man. He will work so hard. His son must not be eating his money. But
as
the son of his son.
Never
that is the
difference.
No, my India.
You get a lot of time to find Indians who are suffering.
No, she was not.
What was revealed to me last week?
Jesus, I got that.
I'm an Indian.
I'm from India.
I said, why are you so successful?
You can say, you will be the
same. We have got a law.
As
Muslims.
Same Muslims.
My son,
Manakana,
will not eat my money.
He
must be living on my father's
money.
Then my money
is
his son. So what I am doing now is not for my son, because he's already well off. I am giving money for his
generation.
Thank you. A good man.
And
inheritance to his children's children. And the wealth of the sinner is laid down for the just
wealth. Jesus.
In Africa,
Africa,
when you grow up and you start working, the parents are
the
wrong. It's me who took you to school. It's me who educated you. If the salary must come to us, if you don't come to us, you are
dead.
Oh.
You are supposed to help me.
Amen.
It is sad.
Thomas!
You see the man. Now, come back to my thing message, my brother.
Always, go! Deals with men just according to the way that their minds run.
I asked a brother, I said, how old are you? He says, 28. Are you married? No, I'm not married. What are you doing? It is not in me, you know. It is not in me. You know these things.
And God will deal with you in that way, because it is not in you to marry. Rapture shall find you a eunuch.
Brother, how old are you? I am 30 years. Are you married? I am not married.
What is it?
Chi. That thought, Brother Jonathan, is not even clear. I am still at school. You shall accumulate a lot of degrees and a lot of degrees and a lot of certificates. But brother, as long as you are not even thinking about marriage, God shall deal with you like that.
Amen. The deal,
Pakatika,
Kole,
Madodadana,
Pakatika. When I was married, they told me, dreams are for the devil. When you dream a girl, then you are on a
death.
It's not always like that. Because dreams are in the Bible. Job chapter 2, verse 25. How can you tell us that the dreams are in the
Bible?
I dreamed about my wife. I dreamed my wife was walking like this with a veil. And a voice spoke to me. Did you know that Ruth Kapisha is your wife? Educated somewhere? Your pastor's sister? Poor moving in slippers. My English was very I learned my English from the university. And in South Africa, when I go there, they say, where did you learn? From the ministry of God, it's so amazing, brother. That means, the other day, I caught somebody say,
Sister,
your husband is a white man. I said, no, because this lady has not seen my wife. But he's a white man. Who has answered? They say, no. That is a black African. So much kitchen. And I saw my wife. Now, you want to marry. You've never thought about any girl in the church. But you wanted to marry. How are you going to marry? The young people of nowadays, me, I'm getting shocked. You have never thought about a girl. Nothing. You are so spiritual. We are so spiritual, brother. What a I know the pastor is going to hear this message. But let me tell you something. That's why we have a lot of misbehaviors among the youths. Especially girls. Our girls, they don't have friends in the church. Because these young brothers, they are too spiritual. Yes! Do you know what caused the fall? You read between the lines when Brother Branham is speaking. Inside the church, where the pastor was God, and Adam was a demon, and Eve was the church, it was spiritual things.
Hello. How shall you eat? And the day that you eat, you shall die. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow. The service is over. Brother Branham says, when she left that church and she went there, she met that boy, handsome boy, with a different message. How are you? And the mama stood there, smelling the perfume, this boy, and was there. You look beautiful, huh? You know her? I've never seen a woman like that. She started hearing.
Eve
was not raped.
Eve
gave herself.
That's right.
These girls, you must greet them.
Our sister.
And the problem is, when the brother is greeting the girl, every eye.
Why did they come? Did I say something wrong?
Your daughter, you won't marry her. Your boy, you won't marry her. She will need somebody to marry. Am I right? What's wrong? Now, the boys are like this. Is she fire? Is the girl fire that can?
I was with Anna yesterday. Was it Wednesday? I was driving with Joshua and Yahan. Where is Anna? She's here. Beautiful girl. She's beautiful. And she came in the car.
With
a very nice roll. And I said, Hannah, where did you get that roll?
Wow, what a roll.
He says, you know what? Brother Benham says, a woman loves to hear. A man loves to see. If you don't tell your wife, I love you so much. Even when I'm at work, I miss you.
You know,
you sometimes I'm just itching.
You know what you are
doing? You are protecting her. When the wife dresses nicely, you must be the first one to give compliment. Because when she goes there, and the serpent there appreciates your wife. So, brother, how old are you? Are you married? No. What?
Say,
no, brother, don't even think about it. And it is true. God will deal with you like that. The day you start to desire, glory, hallelujah. Why?
Say,
he gave a promise. Psalms 37, verse
4.
He will give you the desires of. So it is not sin. I'm talking to the Indian boys and girls now. Amen. I'll take 5 minutes youth
come.
It is not sin to think about a girl in a church. It's not sin.
I just kidding.
How are you going to tell the pastor that you want a girl? Those things of Isaac, brother, they are very rare nowadays. Those are divine orders. A girl does not think about marriage. She does not even think about embracing a child. How is going to give her a husband? You must desire. Go to your mother. Go to your father. Dad, what? I am going home. I want a husband. Those are the prayers that should come. Those
pastor, the church
must pray for me. I want the husband. You are not wrong. And the
angels,
they will pray. Because we want ministers to be born. We want pastors to be born.
Demand the husband.
Yes, sir. No, you don't desire. You have never been prayed about.
God
will deal with you.
Delight.
Okay.
It's like a young man.
And the young man. Now, it's not unnecessary.
And
natural for a young man and the young man to love one another.
Thank you, yes. My brother.
It is not unnatural.
Give
the Lord a hand of grace. You must know what you are talking about in the state government. Because they will catch you. Amen. Back to my quotation, my brother. Did I say I've started teaching now?
Always God
deals with men just according to the way that their mind is
right.
Wow!
Say,
your heart of desire is what is going
to
get
it.
The man that went to the moon. You have read about the man that went to the moon. Which book did he read? That somebody went to the moon. Which reference did he have? That somebody went to the moon. He just came out like this. And he says, my father and my mother, someday I'll go there and come back.
Huh?
I'll go there and come back. You? Yes.
Oh,
how?
Say,
it's not your problem.
I'm
don't ask me how.
Like say,
but oh, what I can tell you.
Is
that thing that you are seeing there.
Which is called the moon.
Me. I'll go there. Come. How I go there? What takes me there? It's not my problem. But someday, I'll go there and come back. The question is this. Did he go? Yes. Oh, he went and he came back.
Wow! Say,
always. God deals with men just according to the way they are. You want a car? Yes. What type of a car?
Benz.
You got a Toyota? No, me I don't want a Benz. Me, I want a Toyota Benz. Why? It is cheaper in maintaining. It has got a smaller tank. And when I'm with my wife, if you give my problems on the road, my wife is there, here, we take it up, we take it home. It is the way my mind is,
right.
And I will never mind what Brother Ben is to do. Because in this message, I will never compete myself with
anything. Yes, sir.
If you want the Ben,
what's
your name? Brother? Yeah. Come, brother. In, brother. Nice shooter. Nice shooter. Nice. Are you married? Praise the Lord. He's married next year. No, no, no. If you have a club, one the events, it's up to you. Because he has his own desire. Me,
Ili,
Toyota this. Why?
Say,
the tires like this, the tank is like this. After 23 children, I don't have a tribe of Israel. After 23. If you have got a tribe of Israel, we can't buy a this. Because where are the
patriots?
If he comes to me, brother Jonathan, pray for me. I want to buy a bed. I will pray for him without being jealous of my God. Because it is his desire to God. So jealous is of the devil. Jealous is of the devil.
Mr. Bandan,
Mr. Bandan,
Mr. Bandan,
Mr. Bandan,
This is my house. Even if you were not there when I was building this, can you come out? If you come, come out.
You are even asking me about my property. A lot of a person who must go into the house is outside the gate. 6 o'clock in the evening.
6 o'clock in the
and the brothers want to come. You can't do this to a human being. You can't do this. You know, I went like this. Just get in the car and the voice spoke. He says, he is right. You are stupid. That's why you brothers, you families,
even more
that God has helped to build a house of yourself. Thank God. God will always be with you. In the way
you thought
of. I was saying, I will not buy a Benz. I don't have a house.
And then I'll
buy a smaller car. You know, then I'm not going to take him to church.
You know, then
check my rounds.
You know,
save money to buy
the check it is a
money. When I'm done, you can shout out as a house. Shout out as a house. Shalom as a house. My wife. Myself, we have built houses. Then I can buy
this.
I'm done. Even if I sleep here,
the
children will say, this guy will prepare for us. Amen. Holy help. That I build a house in Zambia. When Mushamba comes, you must now sleep in my house with the geyser and the aircon and the computer and the towels. You can build a house. You can build a house. Tomorrow. You can have a plot tomorrow by changing your mindset. You can have the car of your choice because all things are possible. That house.
Imagine,
which is not yet finished. You can finish it now. By changing your mindset. By changing your thoughts. By inviting Jesus Christ to drive your thoughts.
Bye-bye.
Keep them out of your bed.
I'm a shari.
I love this scripture. I love it. The one that I'm going to tell you. I'm going to love it. Prepare. That brother is very good. Prepare thy house. Prepare thy way. Break out. And make it fit. People, when they are waking, they are
complaining.
They hear something, they come and then they are waking. How?
Say it.
Well, make it fit.
It has to be written in the field.
For myself. And afterwards, buy a car. I'm reading it wrong. That's God. Our God.
My will
to show you that before you came here, you prepared a body. Before you came on earth, you prepared a body. And then he comes and says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me.
What they don't want
to do. I am going away. To do what?
To make it.
To prepare a place.
So,
we don't want it to be said, where are we going? Where are we going? Where is the door here? The house is prepared. From here we go to the I love this scripture.
Moses is told by God, you want to go there. But others. So you choose 12 people to go there and spy and bring the report. And Moses takes 12 brothers. I want you to notice this. Two of them, the names were written. No names. Two of the 12.
Their
names are written. And there is a purpose. They go there, they see the germs, they come back. Two, they stood there. The ten, they were
Baptists.
We can't. The way we show people there, we can't. I'm telling you,
no one among us
can go there. We can't. Expressing their
thoughts.
Amen.
And God, who gave the promise, the power of thoughts, always God deals with men according to the way their thoughts are having. These people, they are saying,
we can't. It's not God who told them that they can't go.
It is themselves. They told God.
And I feel that because
the
followers
of
God, we will deal with men just according to the way
they are.
And when that service was over, just when it was about to be over, two brothers in Joshua and Caleb. That's why I love the name Joshua, they are not people like this. Joshua, they are strong people.
Joshua,
he says,
shh,
be still, and know that Jehovah,
we are saving, is not sleeping, is not a dead God, is not on the journey,
but is the true God. These brothers, they are wrong on one account.
God that gave a promise
cannot
lie.
Because the God that we are serving, he is the God of our father Abraham. That we shall go there. That's our place. That's our land. These brothers
are lying. Yes. Naturally speaking, we are not able.
At what to know,
but because of the promise. Every promise in the book. Every chapter and every line.
Chapter, you say it's our sex.
Yeah. Why?
Say,
God is not a man.
Ask for
that he can
lie.
Son of man. That he should bow yet to repentance. Time may change. The world may change. Pastors may change. And leaders in the churches may change. The world may change. But the God who gave the promise cannot change. In the end of days, he cannot change.
Joshua,
he says, we are more than able. And Joshua turned his mouth like this.
Joshua,
he says, Lord, we can. The others, we can't.
negative people. Negative people. And the message is full of negative people. But the brothers are so negative. Sisters are so negative. That's why they are language from what you are saying. He's so negative. And they blame the pastor. Why miracles are not in the church? They blame the pastor. But they are the very causes why things are not happening in the church. Brother, not everybody that has come to this message must be your friend. Can I say that again? Mama. And not everybody, sister here, these young girls here, they might all be your friends. They are spirits. Some of them. They will bring your faith down because of their family background. They are mad and fathers, they complain the whole day about the pastor, about the elders of the church. And they pick up that spirit.
Amen.
Do you know why you can't have victory in your Christian life? Friends.
Friends.
I want to meet a brother. I want to meet a sister. I want to sleep there. That when I meet him, the anointing comes in me. And if there is a problem, the problem goes up. That's a problem. Do you know that there are people, when you meet them, even your little faith is finished? I know what I'm talking about. You meet a brother, you are the faith. If I can do that, I'll tell you. I'm going to tell Brother Shai. If I can only do that, brother, my problems are over. How are you? How are you, Brother Jonathan?
How are you, brother? How are you?
Right there. You start feeling your joy. Going down. Demon in my brother. I'm not talking about you. It comes.
Isn't that okay?
When somebody has a demon,
I love
the message on Wednesday. Even on Friday. That one is the message. You know when somebody is in a torment, you will pick others who are resting.
I will put others
who are resting. Because that was the message of Simon. Imagine, brother, the torment of this man.
He
managed to go down the soil and you pick up the prophet of God who is resting. And when the prophet comes out, the first question was, why have you destabilized? It's not everybody who is saying amen, amen,
amen.
You must know who is your friend, especially you young brothers and sisters. No, who should come to your house?
Someone in the country.
In Zambia,
he was complaining.
I knew you, Tam.
Amen. The brother was complaining.
Amaya, I knew you, Tam.
People are not visiting me.
When I was with Shania,
people are not visiting me.
When I was with Shania,
when they have got the phones, they are not visiting me.
I was from when I was
here, brother, that I was thank you, God. That we are not visiting
you.
Thank God. Some of these people, they will drop your faith. Thank God.
Amen.
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 Joshua. He says, we are able. The others, they said, we can't. Always, God
deals with men just according to the word. And Jehovah came and he says, Joshua, Caleb, pick up those people, let's go. You brothers, thank you very much. I don't know whether I should say, may your soul rest in peace, or we shall see you again. We shall not see you again. That's what Brother Branham says. When Jesus said, your fathers are dead, that was eternal separation for
us.
Of your thoughts.
Joshua!
They are dead. Because they said,
we came.
Brother Branham, one of the shortest prayers that I've heard, Brother Branham prayed, is when he says, Lord, keep me away from people that all of these women are doing because they bring my faith
back.
Can the flat battery energize another flat battery? This battery is
right.
Baburu. Amna.
There's no
moto.
Moto. Baburu. Amna moto.
There's no
a flat battery cannot energize another flat battery. It is locked. And from yes, my pastor told me
that.
Be careful about your friends. Be careful. Even today, we are in the church today. Tomorrow, we are going to work. You people who are working in offices, be careful. Brother Ben, come. Be careful. To your friends there. To your friends there. Hey! How are you? I was missing you weekend. You pick up their stories. Don't greet people anyhow. It's a tip that I'm giving.
Amen.
Did I start? I've started preaching.
Oh.
I didn't start it, okay? Now, listen to this. The woman that touched his garment, she thought, I have spent a lot of money, doctors, no one is helping me. But I can find where it is. And if I find where he is, I want to put up a prayer request. I will never say nothing.
No
God, who brought this man here, all
that
I'm asking for, make a way, I find it. If I can only go, I can dance that garment.
I don't know.
And this Bible has given a declaration.
Right
there.
Put it up.
Shit. You have read the message. Standing in the
gap.
That man. With a bill of fire. He picked up the complex. And he started telling the people that he wants to leave the city and go into the bush. Because when he was in that day, restaurant, there came a man, very dead. And that man was sneezing. Culture! And the prophet there. He says to his son, I want to be like that. Culture! The prophet says, I want to be that prophet. He says, that. Are you okay there? The man says, culture! That's the man. Come to my profession. Always, God deals with men just according to the way their minds
right.
Brother Branham said, in the message standing in the
back,
he says, it is saying, cut out your plans, and you will be like that. God telling the prophet, with a bill of fire, this man has prayed for the dead people. They seek a
healed.
The thoughts are coming in
him.
I want to be like a culture. And I want to go there. Yeah. God comes. It is said, cut out your plans. How can you be like that? I said, Lord, I don't want to be like that. It is said, no. Those are your thoughts. Your wife will go to. She won't live up there. And you become a bug. Just as the dream was shown to you.
The second life is for forget from open.
That's very serious.
This is another question.
God is talking to him. Me, I have got a law. And I will never depend on my words. I always give a man his desires. So the way your thoughts are running, I can guarantee you, William Branham, it will happen. You shall become a man. And you will be passing there. And you shall be doing culture. And people, that is William Branham. I pray for this. Yeah. Is that William Branham? Yeah. And it was going to
happen.
The power of your thoughts. Serious, eh?
Amen.
Are you afraid?
Move scared.
I'm giving you tips. The power of your thoughts. They are people. Parents who don't know how to talk even when children do wrong. You have read such parents, especially in my area, the way I come from. They ask a wife, a mother will say, but when I
but you
are the only chief who are you. You are stupid, you are foolish. There is nothing that you will do in this life. You, I have many parents. And always, God will deal with them upon their children. How can you say to your own child, dog? The child that you carry for 9 months. You baby that child. You protected yourself from everything. You told everybody. This is the child. And you are a parent. A boy was done wrong. Somebody will say, I have disowned her.
What is the
child that this child? Can you disown your own child? You are a stupid parent. I'm sorry to use that word. Can you disown your own child? Because my child has done a mistake, then she's not my daughter. My son is not my son. My own blood, my own
loins.
If God was doing it like that, how many would be here? If God was doing it like that, how many would be here? And how many rooms are we doing
here?
People want to capitalize on the mistakes of others. You saw that girl before. You saw where she was going. What did you do as a
believer?
To talk or to
pray?
Now let me say this. Do you know that evil thoughts about people are very affecting? your thoughts, wrong thoughts about a brother has affected him. Take it or leave it. And on the day of judgment, God shall make you answer for your thoughts affecting the brother. Brother Jonathan, is that message? Yes, it's a message. Brother Brennan, he's doing discernment. You have seen it. On the deep corner of the deep. Prayer comes a woman. And she's crying. Then the prophet says, you are not strong yet. Your name is in success. There is a spirit around you. Your pastor told you that you are a witch. Sister, you are not a witch. A pastor told a sister that she's a witch. And that evil spirit was surrounding mother. And when she's walking, I am a witch.
I am a witch.
Is it not Brother Brennan?
Who
is saying, when a brother has done wrong, don't you have a complex
affect?
Because it will affect.
That's very
true.
Believers, we don't know how to talk. Let us admit, we don't know how to talk. Even if you hate me tomorrow, I'm going, I don't say
anything.
Believers, we don't know how
to talk.
On the things that are of you and the things that are lovely. Think.
Amen.
I have got these two quotations. I want to read.
And this
would
have been later.
Then I
won't.
Permission?
Yes.
Brother Brennan reads the scripture in Luke chapter 24 and verse
13.
And he picks up the instruction and preaches a message. When their eyes were open, they knew him. If you follow that message, Brother Brennan says, the reason why he appeared to them, they were thinking about then the reason why he does not appear to us, we don't think about it more. From Monday, they come to Zimbabwe. This is our
brother.
From Monday up to Sunday
morning,
they come. And they talked together. All these things which had happened. When they were talking, their thoughts were full of him. The power of human thoughts. Their thoughts were on him. The thoughts of two brothers changed the Son of God. From whatever he was doing, and he started going into that direction. Hallelujah! Where people were talking about him, and I say this afternoon, your thoughts can bring him where you are. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I can tend to be a Pentecostal now. I can say thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, their thoughts brought
How he would bind the Lord.
And how we would meditate now in the day.
If you notice, as the disciples on the road to Emmaus,
while they were speaking to each other, saying the Lord Jesus,
he stepped right out of the bush and walked with them. And if our minds, I'm closing.
And if our minds
would be more taken up on God and on the things pertaining to God, it would do one thing. It would be so much easier to live victorious in
Christ.
He would be with us. And God bless the preaching of his word. God bless his
teaching.
The power of human thoughts. Your thoughts can bring him where you are. Your thoughts can change your life physically and spiritually.
Your life
can be changed by the power of your thoughts.
That's the reason why
God admitted that what they were doing in Genesis
11
was
going to happen.
Here's my last question.
Genesis.
Chapter 6. My brother,
if evil thoughts.
Listen to this.
If evil thoughts.
Genesis
chapter 6
verse 1 talks about the evil thoughts, and it came to pass when man began to multiply on the face of the earth and daughters were born unto them, then the sons of God saw that the daughters of men that were fed and they took the wives of all of the children, and God said, my spirit shall not always
serve
you. For that is just also a flesh. Yet his flesh shall be hungry. Go down. They were a giant in the earth in those days. And what happened that when the sons of God came unto the daughters of men, and all the children of men, which were born of renown. Now listen. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the every imagination of the thoughts of his heart were evil.
Thoughts
brought down the judgment of God. Evil thoughts. Power they can be. The judgment of God, and the flood came, and people perished because of evil thoughts.
Amen.
How much more? How much more good thoughts, positive thoughts, our thoughts on him, our minds on him, how much more are they going to bring him down here to kill him, to that brother, to that sister, if the evil thoughts brought him down, I do believe positive thoughts can bring him down. To answer our prayers. We've got the power. For the angel has talked with me. Said, my thoughts in heaven was louder than my voice on heaven. That's exactly what it is, brother and sister. But how serious it is. Probably if only we can be conscious about it. See, it's just like the certain things that you cannot do during the light. Because you are conscious that people are aware of what you are doing. Then you can do them in darkness. But when you know that someone is watching you, you will hold yourself appropriately. That's exactly with our thoughts. The prophet says in one place, do right. That's a duty to God. Think right. That's a duty to yourself. You will always become outright.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And even David says, let the words of my mouth and the imagination of my thoughts be acceptable before you. I'm sure that is our prayer in our
time.
And always think right. The prophet says you cannot help the dead. Sure, those are going to come. For sure, they are going to come because they are repenting. And you remember, he says you cannot let that bed make a noise from your head. When it will not come into your mind, just flush it down. When it will talk from your brother, just flush it down.
When you think about a system, some they flush it out. You have the power to do it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is our duty. Do right. That's your duty to God. Think right. That's your duty to yourself. And you always come out right.
Listen,
one more time. You've got the power. Amen. For many years now, Satan tried to stop us. Amen. Well, we pray for the sister. Amen.
We've got the power. In the name of Jesus, we've got the power. In the name of the Lord, oh Satan, we cannot be defeated. We've got the power. In the name of the Lord, for many years now, Satan tries to slow back, like the bride of Jesus, Lord is still alive, like a mighty army, like a marching corps, winning every battle for the Lord on our side. We've got the power in the name of Jesus. We've got the power in the name of the Lord. We cannot get defeated. We've got the power in the name of the Lord. Give me your hand now. Let me feel you get out. We're full of our enemies. Come on,
in the name of Jesus, we go back.
Now I realize what it means just to think. Amen. Lord, I want angelic visitation. Lord, we've been told we're just thinking about you. And when we think of you, you come. Lord Jesus Christ, you want that wonderful experience of angelic visitation. Amen. At the same time, there's a prayer request. Today. Amen. You just show sure by raising your hand. If that is your desire, I need to think. Just to think right. Lord, help me to think right. Amen. Lord, help me to believe in this. Hallelujah. Lord, just help me. And remember, you will wake up to your thoughts. If it is your desire, the Lord is certainly going to help you. Amen. This is also a special request here from Brother Shakata. Amen. From Moringa, Brother Machimura, father-in-law. Amen. He's in Harare Hospital 1-3. He suffered a mild stroke. Amen. On the right side. And we believe God is through God this afternoon. Amen. He can deliver our precious brother. Amen. Surely, if we've any special need again this afternoon, I'm going to ask our precious brother Namini to come forward. Amen. Just pray for all those hands that are laid out. For those people that are saying, Lord, help me, I just want to think. Right? Because you know, you have to think first. And then your thoughts are going to lead you to say right. And when you say the right things, you're going to do the right things. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Tinokutendai masikati ano nekuda kweshoko renyu. Ramakati rakasimbiswa kumusoro kumatenga. Ishe wangu rataurwa pakati pedu. Tinoziva kuti parinouya ishe wangu ari kudereka dzokera risina kuwana chekurekera kuvira. Mune chikonzero ishe wangu nekutaura nesu nemutoo wakadai. Tibatsirei masikati ano ishe wangu nekuda kweshoko renyu. Ndichokwadi makati munhu sezvaanofunga mukati mepfungwa yake ndozvaari. Baba wangu tichibatsirei tikwanise kufunga pamusoro peshoko renyu nekuti shoko renyu ndorine simba guru rekutibatsira. Ishe wangu tinoziva kuti muprofita akatidzidzisa kuti patinogamuchira Ishe Jesu Kristu semuponesi wedu munotipa simba, simba rekuva vana venyu. Asi Ishe wangu tinoziva kuti simba iri rinogavhenwa kana kutungamirirwa nemurayiro. Murayiro wekutenda. Kutenda Ishe wangu kunouya zvakare nekuda kweshoko renyu rimwe chete. Chitipaiwo masikati akadai Ishe wangu. Murayiro wenyu kunova kutenda kuti tigokwanisa kutora shoko renyu tichishandisa kuti ritibatsire. Baba wangu wekudenga, tarirai takasimudza maoko pamberi penyu tichiziva kuti kwamuri ndokunobva rubatsiro rwedu. Muri mubatsiri wedu ari pedyo pedyo panguva yose yekumanikidzwa. Tine hama yedu iri mukati pechipatara cheHarare Hospital. Ishe wangu akaita kastroke. Tenzi wangu Jesu Kristu, ndimi Mwari unopota zvirwere zvedu zvose. Tiri kunamata masikati ano tichirayira Ishe wangu simba rechirwere kuti risarambe rakabata hama yedu nekuda kwekuti ndini mwari hamuziye distance vabatsirei pavari pamwe vakwanise kumuka tezi vangu nekusimbiswa nemi tinonyeketerawo zvakare vari pakati pedu vakasimudza maoko pasi perongo rumwe nerumwe pane chikumbiro ishe imimi ndimunopindura zvikumbiro zvedu zvose muchitipa zvishuwo zvemwoyo yedu yose baba vangu vakati ipromisi yenyu yamakapa baba vangu tikakumbira chinhu muzita renyu munochiita chitibatsirai masikati ano baba tinokunamatai mazvitaiishovo neshoko renyu ramataura kwatiri ngatichivaumbuva patakudzokera kudzimba dzedu tirambe tichifunga pamusoro pezvenyu pamusoro peshoko renyu rimwe chete irori tanzwa kuti mimi munotishanyira kunyange vatumwa venyu vanotishanyira nekuda kuti pfungwa dzedu dzinenge tichifunga pamusoro pedu maita masikati ano baba vangu tinokutendai ivai nevakuru ivai nevadiki ivai nevanhu vose vanga vari muno vachinzwa shoko iri mazvita tedzo vangu wokutenga batsirai hama yedu yataura shoko renyu vanga vachishingaira simba rabuda mavari ridzoseredzeiwo ishe vangu wokutenga tinopa zvinhu zvose mukati memaokonyu nemutenda tichiziva kuti ndimi mwari musingatikundike maita masikati ano tinokumbira muzita ramambo jesu kristu amen.